Test, test, test. Test, test, test. Wonderful. Come one, come all to the GNAC semifinals here at Andy Yosinoff Court. Alex Shipps here with women's basketball on this beautiful Saturday afternoon. We've got the Regis College Pride playing the Emmanuel College Saints. And certainly this is an exciting occasion. The Saints coming off of a victory against Norwich, in which they won decisively. And into this one against Regis, a rematch of a game back in late January. Now, taking a look at the season for the Saints so far, it's been a special tournament run already. They have dominated GNAC competition throughout the season, undefeated in GNAC play. Just a historic run. And they look to continue that here against the Regis College Pride. Regis College, of course, a team very good on the offensive boards and a team with a bit of an interior presence. Regis coming into this tournament very excited, trying to upset the Emmanuel College Saints. We'll get into the game a little bit more on the other side of the clock here. Let's talk about our starting lineup. Starting first for your Regis College Pride, coming in at 13-8 on the season, 11-3 in GNAC play. We've got number 10, Ari Searcy from Santa Rosa, California. Number 14, Courtney Doherty, a sophomore guard. Number 31, Shannon Kelly, a 5'5 senior. Number 33, Valerie Whalen, a senior forward. And number 35, the top scorer on your Regis College Pride, Pam Gonzalez, the junior guard out of Revere, Massachusetts. Their head coach is Samantha Crow. Assistant coach is Leah Spencer. And their captains, Ari Searcy, Marissa Prawl, and Shannon Kelly. Starting for the Saints, Corey Mathis, Jamad Finn, Yanni Chan, Riley LaHiff, and Laura Donna D'Agostino, coached by Andy Yosinoff, Arthur Howell, Megan Kerwin, and Chelsea Dunham. Your assistant coaches will bring it down to the floor for the announcement of your starting lineups. Stay with us here on ECTV. All right, folks, welcome back here. Alex Shipps here on ECTV. We're about to get underway. The GNAC semifinals against Regis Pride. Now, going back to those starting lineups for a moment, that was Corey Mathis starting at guard, Jamad Finn starting at guard, Yanni Chan starting at forward, Riley Lahiff also at forward, and Laura Donna D'Agostino, the senior, rounding out your starting lineup. And for Regis, Ari Searcy, number 10, number 14, Courtney Doherty, number 31, Shannon Kelly, number 33, Valerie Whalen, and number 35, Pan Gonzalez. And just such an exciting showdown here as the Saints come out here in their white jerseys. They've got yellow numbering, blue lettering, and Regis College coming in their red with white lettering. It'll be D'Agostino and Searcy to tip it off. And we're about to be underway. There we go, and the Saints control the tip thanks to Riley Lahiff, and Mathis is pushing. Gets into the corner to Jamad Finn, who checks her feet. High pass, but now Saints far side trying to get it inside. It'll be Riley Lahiff taking a jumper and hits the back iron. Whalen controls the rebound. Whalen, one of the top rebounders in the GNAC. More on her later. You see Kelly getting over to Gonzalez. Gonzalez, the top scorer, with Andy just behind her. Now Regis, left shoulder. Whalen trying to generate some offense here. Over to Searcy. Searcy guarded by Finn. She's stuck. Gets it to Doherty on the handoff. Doherty, nice take. Lost the ball, and it'll be Saints possession. A turnover there by Courtney Doherty. Courtney Doherty, a very good distributor and a three-point shooter as well. One of the more underrated players on Regis. But now we reset the Saints in a 0-0 game here early on. Mathis hits it to Lahiff. Now top of the key. Jamad Finn thought about a step back. Now over to Corey Mathis. She takes a step just inside the three-point line, and she'll knock that down. Saints now getting into their signature press. Doherty over to Searcy. Searcy trying to fight through a sea of hands. She's stuck in the backcourt. Finally gets it over to Gonzalez, and they break the Saints press. Doherty thought about it, trapped in the corner by Mathis. Ball was tipped, and I believe it's another turnover for Regis. So Regis, two turnovers in a little bit over a minute, and the Saints defense already working quite well. Saints up 2-0. Got a chance to smoke to Jamad Finn, who currently has possession. Very excited for a game like this. In her final year of eligibility, she has been terrific for the Saints, looking to build on that here. As you see Yanni Chan get it out to Jamad Finn. That's a three! Bounces, hit the support wire, and that'll be a turnover. Ball goes back to the Pride. And as we look at Pam Gonzalez, the inbounder here, she had quite a few turnovers early on in that game. As it's stolen away! Ryan Lahiff goes left, he can't finish. Rebound by Chan, it looks like. She's stuck on the baseline, ball is loose, stolen by Searcy. Now Gonzalez going to push it the other way. Ball is loose. Almost a turnover on the double team instead. It's going to be Kelly in the corner for three and hits the back iron. So Finn will now push it over to Lahiff. That pass is almost stolen away by Ari Searcy. That's a name you're going to hear a lot. And for the Saints, their goal is going to be to keep her off the glass. She's also very effective. This is a Regis team with a great interior presence, a lot of blocks. They win the game on the boards a lot of the time as well. As now Chan steps into a jumper, looking for her first points of the tournament. No such luck there. Rebound by Jamad Finn. Great track down. And now Corey Mathis at the top of the key. Gets it back to Finn. Finn thought about it. Gets it over to D'Agostino. Now back to Mathis. Mathis with the long jumper. No good. Rebound by Chan. Wide open. And there are her first points of the tournament. Yanni Chan getting on the board. So active on the offensive glass as well. Kelly now pushing. Doherty ahead. Doherty faked, thought about, almost traveled. They don't call it. Ball is stolen by Lahiff. Now Finn trying to push it. Loose. Lahiff gets it back. Goes inside. Good take to the basket. Ball is loose. And a foul called. And it looks like that's going to go against Valerie Whalen. Whalen, such a huge part of Regis's defense, as you see D'Agostino stepping into a very polished jump shot. Always so reliable for her. That free throw line jumper. Now you see Kelly trying to push it up the floor. Gets it to Searcy. And Regis really out of whack here, clearly disrupted by the Saints defense. Saints already up 6-0 in the early goings. Gonzalez over to Whalen. Whalen gets it inside to Gonzalez. Gonzalez is fouled by Chan. Chan was going for the block, but looks like she got her right hand on it there. Now let's talk about Regis a little bit here. And particularly Pam Gonzalez, who has paced all scorers for the Pride. Very even scorer, someone who can take in the paint, can also shoot the three very well. And let's talk more about that as well. She averages 17 points per game, a three-point threat. She shoots 37% from three. She found some rhythm against the Saints in the third quarter of the last game, as you see her put two on the board there. We'll see what she brings to the table. Going to have to really deliver here for Regis. Regis will need all the scoring they can get. Not a particularly deep team in the Pride. Lahiff thought about it, gets it to the top of the key. Now over to Chan. D'Agostino is baseline. Great ball movement by the Saints. And Lahiff with the travel, unfortunately, in the paint. They tried to get it inside to her, and she's looking for that jumper. But Regis has been guarding that high post pretty well, trying to deny any sort of inside look. Gonzalez, almost a turnover there. She had a couple head-scratching turnovers in the last one. Now Regis trying to push it up the floor. Whalen trying to get inside. She's blocked by D'Agostino, but Searcy on the board. Now trying to drive it herself. Good take. But wide off the rim. No good. Chan now looking over to D'Agostino. D'Agostino goes all the way to the basket. Floats it up and in for two. And Lauren D'Agostino, she's got four already. Unfortunately, the Saints commit a foul in the backcourt just after the basket. That's the Saints' second team foul. First personal for Jamad Finn. Again, the Saints team so excited, so focused. This game, of course, was supposed to be yesterday at about 7 o'clock, but the snowstorm pushed us back. So here we are on a Saturday afternoon, and a beautiful one to say the least. Whalen looking inside, gets it to Gonzalez. Gonzalez sort of in no woman's land, and the ball is stolen away, picked up by Lahiff. Mathis looking to get it to Jamad Finn. Jamad thought about it. That's a three. No good. Jamad emerging as one of the top three-point shooters in the nation in D3 women's basketball. On the other end, though, Courtney Doherty, a good take. She's fouled and will go to the line for two. And that's Yanni's first personal. And Wild will come into the game for Chan. And for Regis, that's Olivia Pacheco coming in for Searcy. As you hear the crowd here, great crowd at Andy Yosinoff Court as the court starts to fill up with fans. Some Regis, mostly Emmanuel here, as you would imagine. Parents, students, alumni, prospects, a lot of exciting moments coming today, and this crowd is really going to feed off of it. So it's 8-4 Emmanuel in the early goings. Almost 5 minutes lapsed, and an easy steal for Courtney Doherty on the other end. She'll take it for two. And Courtney Doherty with another basket there. She hit the free throws. And then a basket. Jamad Finn takes it right back against the Saints to double figures. It's 10-6. What a take by Jamad Finn. Almost stole it away on the inbounds pass as well. Jamad Finn. Let's talk about Jamad Finn a little bit more. Someone who's talked about some of the weaknesses that she saw in the Pride's defense. It's below the free throw line in the right side. So as you see there, her getting below the free throw line, a good take, and she gets two. Whalen now trying to move the ball all the way to Doherty in the corner. That's a good look for Regis, and Doherty knocks it down. Nothing but net. Courtney Doherty making a statement in the early going. She has 7 out of Regis's 9 points. Lahiff looking inside to D'Agostino. D'Agostino seeing two. Now over to Wild. Wild gets it out to Corey Mathis. And that appears to be an offensive foul against D'Agostino. That's only her first foul, so nothing to sweat about there. And about this game so far, Emmanuel shooting just 41% from the field, 4 turnovers. Regis has 5 turnovers on 40% shooting. Neither offense exactly gelling right now. And a close one early. Whelan playing a lot of high post. It's stolen by Metella. She was the spark plug in the Norwich game. She takes it to the basket and scores! Metella, someone who ignites this women's basketball team with a great take to the basket there. Off the steal, she had quite a few steals in the Norwich game, looking to continue off that success. She had 5 steals, 11 points, and 2 assists. Kelly lost it. Now the Saints pushing again. It's Jamaat Finn. And she stops, gets it over to Lehiff. Lehiff had a good look for a moment there. Now gets it back near side. That's going to be Finn on the 3. No good. Wild decides not to contest the rebound as Gonzalez will push it the other way. Again, she can shoot it. Someone you have to keep your eye on throughout. And Metella went for the steal. And Wild picked it up. And a foul then called against Gonzalez. That goes against Pam Gonzalez. And Whalen comes out. Searcy coming in. Ari Searcy, really someone who is a terrific offensive rebounder and someone that the Saints have to constantly ID on defense to make sure that she's boxed out, she's out of position to reset the possession. So she's someone to keep an eye on, someone that the Saints really took out of the game. Searcy struggled from the field, 1-for-10 in the last matchup here a month ago. Faust in the game for the Saints. Gets it over Metella. Metella fires away and got it. She can knock those down. She's got 5 early. Arguably the MVP of the GNAC quarterfinals. Now in the semifinals, stepping up to the plate. You hear the Saints bench cheering. Gonzalez is going to try a 3 and get her own. And for a scorer like her, good to see that shot fall. She's got 5 early on. She's quite the scorer, as we mentioned before. Metella over to Finn. The Finn is far side. Now they get it inside to Wild. That pass is tipped. They were looking for Wild drifting towards the left block. Still Saints possession. They get into Wild. Wild gets it inside to Finn. Finn turns and can't quite finish it. Ball's tipped. Finn picks it up. Gets it over to D'Agostino. D'Agostino, 1 dribble. Saw some contact. Ball's loose. But then secured. No, it's not. The Saints get a steal. D'Agostino goes inside, and she is fouled by Courtney Doherty. And the Saints, so persistent. You'd love to see the backcourt pressure, something that Andy Yosinoff has really been iconic for over these years. And that's one thing about Emmanuel Saints basketball. Always great press defense, as D'Agostino heads to the line here. And she makes her first. D'Agostino has 5 early on. Just so consistent. One of the more physical bigs in the GNAC. Probably the best big in the GNAC. And she continues to show why. Throughout this season, she has just been excellent. Doherty pushing up the floor, breaks the press. Over to Searcy, near side. Now top of the key. Gonzalez thought about a 3. Now going inside. Gets it over for the layup. And a basket there for Regis. Great feed from Gonzalez. And she hit Pacheco. It's 17-14, Emmanuel. Metella gets it over to Caitlin Barker. Far side, 3, she got it. Barker just coming into the game recently. And good to see her getting a groove. Really was a huge reason why the Saints were able to pull away early on in that regular season matchup we've harkened back to a couple times here. And Barker commits her first personal. And Shannon Kelly coming into the game. Kelly yet to get on the board here. Misses her first. And Shannon Kelly, 71% from the free throw line. Misses both there. And Olivia Wilde, or rather, Allison Wilde, with a great box out on Searcy, what we talked about earlier. So the Saints have the possession. Good move by Faust in the corner to Barker. Now Saints going to reset, slow things down a little bit. Wilde thought about a three. She hit a couple in the previous game. Now over to Faust. Faust is going to tee up a three. No good. Good rebound by Wilde. And she'll go to the line to shoot two. And Ari Searcy committing the foul there. And Wilde versus Searcy, that's certainly a matchup to keep an eye on. Wilde, a player in her first year here at Emmanuel, has been so excellent. Hit the game-winning shot against St. Joseph's Maine. She's had several great moments, just been consistently excellent as a backup big. And this is a Saints team that has incredible depth. So certainly admirable on that end. And Wilde hits both. Eubanks will come in for D'Agostino as it is 21-14 with a minute to go here in this first quarter. Gonzalez going to bring it up. Gets a screen from Whalen. Waves it off. Whalen now over back to Gonzalez. Gonzalez looking for something, but seeing Wilde and sort of tracked by Metella. Kelly gets into the free throw line, then out to Doherty, who rolls out on the three. Doherty, again, a knockdown shooter, misses one there. So with about 30 seconds left, the Saints could go 2-for-1 if they push it. Let's see what they do here. Inside to Eubanks. Eubanks tried to get it to Wilde, kind of forced it in there, and it's stolen away. Gonzalez now pushing it the other way. And Regis can dribble this thing out. The second quarter, if they want, get a last shot. They won't. They go for the quick three. Faust controls the rebound, and now the Saints have numbers. 3-on-2. Faust over to Barker in the corner. That's a three. It's good. Caitlin Barker with a huge three for the Saints just before the first quarter buzzer. It's 24-14. And Doherty tried a three at the horn. It won't count, and it's no good. End of the first quarter. The Saints lead 24-14. Solid offensive basketball, defensively pretty good as well. And in that first quarter, Saints shot 45% from the field, made 3 of 8 threes. That's the real difference maker. Regis, 8 turnovers. And the Saints capitalized 9 points off of turnovers, winning the rebound battle 9-6. That's a huge key again. This is a Regis team that can really crash the boards. And Emmanuel College doing an excellent job of controlling the glass. Really the key to this game is how well the Saints can defend the paint. They've shown time and time again that they dominate the interior. And so far, no different here. Now let's talk about a little bit of history before we head into the second quarter. The Saints are 3-1 versus the Pride since the latter joined the GNAC in 2018. Emmanuel beat Regis last month, again, 71-46. They held them to 29% shooting and out-rebounded them by 7, 44-37. This is a Saints team that knows that's really where a game like this is won. As you see Barker, Metella, Lahiff, Eubanks, and Faust come in to start this quarter. Gonzalez, Doherty, Whalen, Pacheco, and Kelly for Regis. And Kelly bringing it up the floor near the top of the key. Now over to Gonzalez, who probably gets more touches on this team than anyone else as their primary scorer, looking to get it inside to Whalen. Instead, tees up a three, and that one rolls out. Another bad bounce for Regis. Saints going the other way. Metella over to Faust. Faust trying to run the offense. Barker cross court over to Metella. Metella, some nifty crossover moves. Now back over to Barker. Lahiff over to Metella. That's a three. It's off the mark, well short. Ball is loose for a moment. Eubanks and Whalen were fighting for it. And the foul will go against Eubanks. Saints always going for the steal, even off the rebound. You love that kind of aggression, but unfortunately, that is the other side of the coin. You pick up fouls like that. So Yanni Chan coming into the game shortly. Currently Finn in. She just substituted for Faust. And there's a floater there by Kelly. No good. Rebound, Whalen. That ball is tipped around. Good hustle play by Lahiff. Two players on the ground. We're going to get a jump ball. And it goes Emmanuel's way. So early on in the second quarter, neither team has scored. And D'Agostino coming in, as we mentioned before, Chan back in the game. Chan has been such a spark plug for this team, similar to the way Metella is. Just 2 points early. You're going to see a lot from her. Risky pass there and is stolen away by Regis. Foul committed by Jamad Finn going for the steal. Saints have been trying to force it inside a few times, and that's led to some untimely turnovers. Still up by 10 early on here. And the winner of this game, we'll talk about who they'll play next. The winner of the Albertus St. Joseph Maine game. That game is currently 3-2, just got underway over at Albertus Magnus. So keep an eye on that one. We'll keep you live for that as the Saints get a stop there. Jamad Finn pushing it up. Saints try to make it fast paced if they can. Finn saw three bodies, now going to run it back. Over to Lahiff. She steps in. No. Over to Chan now. Corner three again. It's good. The Saints making good use of that left corner three. Shots falling early. And Chan with another basket. Saints lead 27-14. Gonzalez. Crossover was over to Whalen. Whalen, couple ball fakes. And Lahiff thought about getting another steal. And Riley Lahiff, a high basketball IQ, someone who contributes in so many ways, and one of her biggest contributions, she picks up a lot of steals. Good hands always for her. Almost got the steal there. Pride get it inbounded to Doherty. Whalen now looking inside. Passes tipped around, and Eubanks picked it up. She was fouled by Whalen. So Valerie Whalen already with two, something to keep an eye on. Valerie Whalen, one of the top rebounders in the GNAC, taking her out of the equation early, could be huge for the Saints, who are already doing pretty well on the boards. Liv, a couple ball fakes, gets it over to Mathis. Mathis steps into another jumper. No, good rebound by D'Agostino, though. She puts it back in for two. And the Saints' lead is up to 15 now. Pressure by Doherty. Almost lost it. Then Searcy picks up, fighting through. And then D'Agostino picks it up. But she was out of bounds. But this crowd getting into it. And what has been a thrilling game so far. And Regis calling a timeout there, down by 15. And Regis, if you're coach Samantha Crow, you understand that you can't look at a deficit like this early on. A key timeout to try to reset things in what has certainly been a challenging go of things already. Regis College shooting just 4 of 10 from the field because of 11 turnovers. The Saints have taken 14 more shots, 11 of 24 from the field, 4 of 10 from 3. They've got 11 points off of turnovers. They're winning the rebound battle, 12 to 8. Regis only 2 offensive rebounds, something that you can't have for a team that relies so heavily on getting things done in the paint. Gonzalez bringing up the court. Over to Kelly, now guarded by Mathis. She's now by the Saints sideline. That ball is thrown inside to Searcy, who's quickly fouled by Hunt. Hunt's coming in the game, and one thing you can say about Angel Hunt, she just subbed in, hungry. Someone who has really made the most of her minutes when she had it. It's been limited because she's still working her way into the rotation, as that ball is tipped by Chan. Goes out of bounds, staying here with Regis. 6:51 to play here in the first half. And if you look at Regis right now, they're scoring. It has been quiet for a while. Courtney Doherty has 7, Gonzalez has 5. Only 2 points outside of them. And that's a huge problem for a Saints team that distributes the ball so well. A clear depth advantage on display. That was a risky shot. Searcy controls the board, though. And Regis will get a fresh possession. Gonzalez now crossover move on Lahiff. Wild on the release, and the Saints get the board. Now pushing it down the other way. Chan steps into a layup, and she got it. Great feed down court from Corey Mathis, and the Saints have hit the 30 spot with still 6 minutes to play in the second quarter. Searcy trying to feed it inside somehow. Someone who just came into the game, Evelyn Donis, looking to capitalize. Regis trying to do something new here as that short lineup of theirs is really struggling. Again, when you get down early and you don't have many players that you can rotate in, it's very difficult to work your way back, especially against the Saints team that they know how to keep a lead, I mean, to say the least. Regis has not scored in this quarter yet. That pass is stolen away. Saints with another steal. Now Lahiff going up court, trying to step into it. Over to Chan. Chan thought about it. Now going to bring it up to the left three-point shoulder. Gets it back after passing it to D'Agostino. Short on the three. And Corey Mathis going for the board there. Commits the foul against Gonzalez. And so that is Mathis's first. Fourth team foul, so the Saints just need to be a little careful on the fouls. That could be one way Regis could work their way back and slow this game down. Instead, it's a steal by Chan. Chan wants to go all the way with it. Great, almost a great finish. Ball's tipped around. And Searcy controls again. Searcy has been much better on the boards today. One of the lone bright spots for Regis. And another foul called here. And a foul there going against Corey Mathis, who is quickly substituted for Metella. And that was a real turning point in the Norwich game when Metella came in, made some huge plays, got some steals, knocked down some threes, and helped the Saints put away the Cadets for good. Had a couple big plays in this one already. And Doherty gets Regis on the board here in the second quarter. Saints lights out defense. Has only surrendered 1 point in the early goings. Metella by the St. Bernard Dogier. Now inside to Hunt. Ball's tipped around. Hunt gets it back on the baseline. Tries to get it over to Metella cross court. That's a three right down the pipe for Metella. She has been primed and ready to go. She's got 8 already. And the Saints are up by 19. Whalen quickly gets 2 back. Valerie Whalen, someone who can score on the low post, doing so right there. But the Saints doubling up on Regis Ohar. Flashy pass from Chan over to D'Agostino. Ball tips around. And then how about Riley Lahiff knocking down a patented shoulder jumper. Lahiff, her first 2 of the game, someone who contributes in a myriad of ways, getting her first points. Gonzalez trying to get a 3 going. No. Rebound by Hunt. She thought about the football pass over to Chan, something that worked out earlier in this one. Chan, couple ball fakes, gets it inside to Hunt. Hunt, easy jumper, got it. And Angel Hunt, someone who knows how to work that high post just below the free throw line, finds a weak spot in the defense, and the Saints now have 12 points in this second quarter alone, or make that 14 points. They lead 38-17 in what has been just excellent from the Saints. And if we look back here to the last time, I mean, Regis, this game was at 15-12. Actually, it was at This game was at 15-12 with 2:44 to go in the first period. Since then, the Saints have outscored Regis 26-2. My goodness, make that 26-5. And this is something that they've done throughout the season. Consistently putting together these dominant runs where you can't score on them. And they're getting any shot they want. The Saints just distribute the ball so well. That's been the secret to their success during this outstanding run. As the ball is stolen away, Lahiff steps into a jumper and swishes it home. Saints up 40-17. Lahiff with their second basket of the day. Doherty now on the other end. Gets into the paint against D'Agostino. Shot is wild. D'Agostino did a great job altering the shot. Chan handles it. Gets it over to Metella. Metella scores! Two long, quick passes by the Saints. And the dominance continues. Already up by 25. This thing has ballooned out of control very quickly. And you gotta love this. Emmanuel College Saints basketball. We're in just the second period. The Saints have been excellent as Searcy steps into a jumper, or a bank shot. As you see, Wild on the other end goes inside. No good, gets her own rebound. Easy follow through for two. And Coach Crow, upset with that, calls a timeout. And for Wild now, three on the day. And the Saints are getting whatever they want in the paint now. And it's funny because this is something that we had really hyped up in the pregame, the interior presence of Regis. They get a lot of blocks, they crash the boards. When I mentioned it to Jamad Finn, she sort of laughed it off. She didn't really see them as too fearsome down low. And the way that Regis has performed today, I have to say that that confidence was deserved. And for Emmanuel doing such a good job altering shots by Regis in the paint. Andy mentioned in the pregame that physical content and boxing out is really what's going to make a difference in winning the paint battle, and the Saints have done that excellently here early on as a foul committed by Chan trying to go for a steal. And that should be Chan's second personal. As Caitlin Barker will come in for her. And for Regis, just struggling to find any answers here on a rough Saturday at Andy Yosinoff Court. This is a game, once again, that was supposed to be played last night at about 7 p.m. Game was delayed due to a snowstorm. And that's how we ended up here. And Emmanuel said it was a little bit of a letdown at first, but they really rallied around it. Got another good practice in, and as you see here, looking like a well-oiled machine. Barker goes inside, then back out to Wild. Now Eubanks to Lahiff, top of the three-point key. Steps into a jumper. No. Good rebound, though, by Eubanks, and she follows through. The Saints really taking advantage of that left block. They've knocked down quite a few layups from there, and Eubanks using her length. An up-and-coming player for the Saints. Very exciting to see what she brings to the table in the future. Here at Andy Yosinoff Court and on the road, of course. Saints up by 25. Gonzalez now over to Kelly. They look inside to Searcy. Searcy with the ball fake. Goes baseline. Steps into a layup. And she's fouled. A good take by Searcy. She has just 2 points on the day. And again, sort of a lone bright spot on Regis. Searcy makes her first free throw. Just three rebounds, but someone who's really been an impact player. Courtney Doherty has also been big for Regis, but still, you look at that deficit, and this has all the makings of another Saints defensive masterpiece, something that we've seen so many times throughout the season in what has been a very memorable run. Emmanuel looking to continue that and appear in their third consecutive GNAC championship. We'll see if they can get that done. Barker, far side, goes in the paint, throws up a wild shot. Ball was loose, a fight for it. And it will be a jump ball that goes to Regis. But Saints playing hard, hustling hard. Let's talk scoring right now for the Saints. Look at this distribution. The only player right now that hasn't scored is Amari Faust. Metello with 10, D'Agostino with 8, Chan with 7, Barker with 6, Lahiff with 4, Wild with 3. And then we've got 4 players with 2. So the Saints distributing the ball evenly as they do so often. Good take by Courtney Doherty on the other end, right hand, going right. And she finishes that one. She's got 12 already. And Doherty played pretty well in the last matchup. So a guard that can exploit the offense. That is a weak point for the Saints, is guards that can beat us off the dribble. The Saints have done a pretty good job overall staying front in front of whoever they're guarding. That one short by Metella. Kelly looking to get it into Whalen. Whalen operating off of the left block, a fake. Tried to kick it back out to Kelly, and it's tipped by Caitlin Barker. With 56 seconds left in this half, Saints could get to 50. And have just played spectacularly here. Game got off to somewhat of a slow start, but then got out of hand very quickly. And Searcy tried a three, no good off the glass. Barker is going to hold it. Now Metella near side, over to Wild. Wild near the Regis bench. Lahiff trying to fight through Gonzalez. Trying to look for a lane, doesn't have one. Gets it over to Barker. Barker threw it off of Metella's head. Metella commits a quick foul, probably for the better, because Doherty would have taken that right to the hoop. Unfortunately, that will be free throws. Olivia Metella's first personal. And for Courtney Doherty, averaging 11.5 per game. And a 68.6% free throw shooter. Looking to add to her totals here early. Knocks down the first. So with 26.2 to go, the Saints looking for the last shot. And the bench is all smiles in what has been just a decisive blowout so far. Metella seeing some pressure from Regis in the backcourt, particularly Doherty, but breaks the press anyway. Great dribble move. She has great ball handling skills, very underrated in that department. And she's someone, something that she told me is that she really feeds off the energy of her teammates and the fans here. And I think that's why she's been even bigger in the playoffs. She just knows how to bounce off of that energy and make big plays. Doherty was pressured and then stolen by Metella. Metella should have a good look. Can't quite get it to go, and it would have been late anyway. But the Saints up by 19 at the half, 46-27. They have been excellent in really all facets of the game, particularly defensively, forcing Regis to 37% shooting, 15 turnovers. The Saints have turned those turnovers into 13 points. They've gotten whatever they wanted on the inside, and that's how you get that 19-point lead. But stay with us here. We'll be back after the halftime break to break down the halftime stats and give you a look around the GNAC as we see who the Saints will face tomorrow, assuming results hold here. Probably a safe bet. But in any case, Alex Ships for ECTV. Stay with us through the half. We'll be back with first halftime stats after this here on ECTV.
appreciate that. Yeah, usually I'm with my partner Matt on it, my broadcast partner. But back on play by play. Appreciate it, though. I was going to mention that at the end of the half. I'm excited about that. I'll make sure to mention that on the broadcast if you come.
Welcome back, everybody, to the second half of the GNAC semifinals here at Andy Yosinoff Court Women's Basketball, Regis Pride at Emmanuel College. And what a first half for the Saints. And where do we even begin? The defense has been terrific for the Saints. They've given up just 7 made field goals, forcing Regis into 37% shooting, 15 turnovers. and they've limited the Pride's best scorer, Pam Gonzalez, to just 5 points. They've dominated in the paint, 16-10, 13 points off of those aforementioned turnovers. So Emmanuel just producing in all sorts of ways. 13-2, second chance points, 8-2 on the fast break. And how about this stat? 23-2, the Saints are winning the bench battle. Saints getting contributions all across the board. Only two players have not scored. That's Amari Faust and Kedden. So the Saints getting it done so many ways. Only one player in double figures. That's Olivia Metella. She's got 10 on 2 of 3 from downtown, 4 of 6 from the field. Kaitlin Barker's got 6. D'Agostino's got 8, as well as 3 rebounds. 4 points for Lahiff, 7 points for Yanni Chan, and several players have also gotten the board as well. All the Saints starters have scored. It has been an excellent game. Only thing Andy wasn't happy about was the last minute or so of that half. But what he did say about it, aside from that final minute or so, was that it was the best half all year and maybe in many years for his team. So the Saints, just terrific in so many ways. Regis really in a tough spot here, down by 19 on the road. I could tell you it's not looking good, but you already knew that. So for Regis, I guess try to slow this game down. For Emmanuel, just keep your foot on the gas pedal. Saints eyeing their third consecutive appearance in the GNAC Championship. Remember, they won those first two against St. Joseph, Maine. And St. Joseph's Maine in an interesting game here against Albertus Magnus. We'll give you the score in just a moment here. The other GNAC game going on today, 35-32, Albertus leads with 1:49 to go in the second quarter. An exciting game there as well. That one looking to be a lot closer than the blowout we have seen today at Andy Yosinoff Court. With about 10 seconds left before we head into the third quarter, the Saints bring out Mathis, Finn, Chan, Lahiff, and D'Agostino. And we'll see who Regis brings out. For Regis, it's going to be Valerie Whalen, number 33. It's going to be Kelly, Searcy, Gonzalez, and Doherty. Finn will inbound. It'll start with Saints possession. And, I mean, what more can you say about Emmanuel? You are watching just a well-oiled machine over the years, and this year especially. They've won their games with great team defense, allowing a league low 53 points per game. They've only given up 27. Again, 7 field goals. And offensive chemistry, 7th in the nation assists. You've seen how many players score it as Finn goes inside and puts it off the window for 2. That was going left. And she scores. Jamad Finn with her 2nd basket of the day. And the Saints getting close to 50 here. And another astounding stat. The Saints have taken 38 shots. Regis has taken 19. They've taken twice as many attempts because of all those turnovers. As Doherty gets the rebound, Whalen, a jumper is good. Whalen stepping outside of her usual low post, and she's all net for her 2nd basket of the game. Finn was near side. Now top of the key over to Chan, who's far side. Free throw line. It was D'Agostino, but it was turned over. Whalen picked D'Agostino off now. Gonzalez going the other way. Nice take. The basket can't finish. Rebound by Whalen. She can't score either. Searcy gets another board. Now Doherty near side. Over to Kelly. Kelly with a couple ball fakes, and she will reset the offense with 11 on the shot clock. Searcy trying to get a lane going left. Bangs off of D'Agostino and finishes. Searcy with a good take. Now Ari Searcy, the senior forward, someone who's played in some big games for Regis over the years, is Chan with a nice take, and she is fouled by Gonzalez. That was a bit of a tough collision there. And Gonzalez, just her 2nd personal. And for Chan, someone who already with 7, such a key impact player in her first year with the Saints. We're very excited here at the athletic department to see what she brings to the table. So Chan makes her first. Second one, no good. Rebound, Lahiff. Another offensive rebound. Now over to Corey Mathis, who thought about feeding Chan. Now she does. Chan, that's a long jumper. It's good. Quick release by Yanni Chan. And she knocks it down near the three-point line. That's a turnover, a miscommunication by Gonzalez and Courtney Doherty. And the Saints, a 20-point lead. The ball. Only enemy is the clock, but the Saints can slow this game down if they need to. Mathis now on the handoff. Tries to get in the paint just past the free throw line. That's going to be a two from Yanni Chan, and she got it. Yanni Chan. It looks like they're saying that's a three. That was a long shot either way. And Yanni Chan showcasing some perimeter touch here. Doherty into Whalen. Whalen on the right block. Couldn't quite bank it off glass, but got her own board and scores there. Andy, not exactly thrilled about that, but when you're up by 20, it's hard to complain too much or have too much of a gripe. Good take by Jamad Finn, and she finishes in midair. Jamad Finn went left, finished right. Just dealt with the contact very well. Jamad Finn has gotten better and better at reading contact in the paint, and it's shown in this game. And Riley Lahiff, he's always a little surprised when she commits a foul like that, but called for it there against number 35 on Regis. Whalen in the three-point corner goes cross-court to Doherty, who steps into a elbow jumper, can't make it. And Corey Mathis looking long for Yanni Chan. Chan stepping into it, short on the floater. And Lahiff tried to save it on the baseline, but unfortunately stepped out of bounds. It'll be Regis ball, and the Saints setting up in that press they've become so well known for. It's a 1-2-1-1. And Doherty trying to break it. She does right there. Actually, that was Kelly, who's done a decent job of that all day. Now Gonzalez at the free throw line, seeing two. Nice fake by Doherty. Gets it back out to Gonzalez. Two-woman game there, and Gonzalez finishes the job. So she's got eight now. As what a crossover move by Corey Mathis. Got the bench talking. D'Agostino got it inside to Jamad Finn on the left block. She's fouled. And Shannon Kelly committing the foul there. And again, let's go back to that GNAC matchup. We'll keep an eye on that one. As Faust tries to go inside. Good take, and now she's on the board. Amari Faust, good take. Going left again. That left block has really been a sore spot for Regis. Nice steal by Finn. Chan shovels it over to Lahiff. Lahiff goes inside, and she will go walk to the other end of the court. It's an offensive foul. Looked like free throws, but not such. Albertus Magnus, by the way, up 37-34 on St. Joseph's, Maine. Something we'll keep an eye on and keep you posted as we go along in this broadcast here. Alex Shipps at ECTV. Brought to you by Coca-Cola, the official drink of the Emmanuel College Athletic Department. Another steal by the Saints, by the way. Faust, nice crossover moves on Whalen. Whalen was holding on by a shoestring, trying to keep up with her. Finn open. How about it? Jamad Finn gets the Saints to the 60 spot. And she's got nine of her own. Kelly, it looked like was blocked, but you could hear the contact. So Kelly will go to the line. And I remember going into the Regis game earlier this season and thinking, you know, there could be some upset potentially. Regis did, in fact, beat the Saints back in 2020. That was another year where the Saints were terrific, won the GNAC championship, made it to the NCAA tournament, but they happened to lose at Regis on the road. But this Saints team has taken care of business on that occasion and in this matchup. And it's been fun to watch. And Kelly splits a pair. She's got a point on day. What a move by Finn. And she hits. Jamad Finn on the snatchback. And Yanni Chan getting excited. The bench having some fun now. As Kelly misses. Gonzalez the rebound. No, rebound wild. And Faust sees Jamad Finn again. Finn, crossover move. Now goes back to the left three-point shoulder. Now over to Mattella on the opposite side. Inside the block to D'Agostino. She can't quite finish on that turnaround short jumper of hers that she's become so good at over the years with Emmanuel. And Pacheco hits a jumper on the right block. Mattella, for a second, thought she might have a path to the basket. Instead, brings it back out. Now inside center paint for D'Agostino. She was going to turn. Instead, kicks it out. And Mattella, no good. But rebound, Amari Faust, another offensive rebound. And Faust tries to finish in a jump ball. Good defensive play by Courtney Doherty. Good hands in the lane. And unfortunately, a jump ball. So Kira Eubanks will come in for Lauren D'Agostino. Again, Eubanks, an up-and-comer on this Saints roster. The Saints team has so much depth that you don't always get to see the talent of the Saints bench, but it's certainly there. That's a three by Gonzalez. So it's 63-42. Gonzalez, the second player for Regis in double figures. Gonzalez and Doherty have combined for 25, but outside of that, just 17 points. And you just can't afford that against a team that plays like the Saints. Really another caliber of D3 basketball. Mattella knocks it down. And the Saints' lead just continues to balloon here. Now up to 24. I mean, how about it? 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Barker will come into the game soon. And a foul on the entry pass committed by, looks to be Allison Wild. As Finn comes out for Caitlin Barker. Barker, someone who's worked her way up in the program. Be interesting to see what her role will be throughout this tournament, but also in the upcoming season. A turnover, again, this is an unforced error. Regis has had their share of those, but Emmanuel just so good in the passing lane, not letting up anything in the paint. I mean, the way they've denied entry passes, stayed glued physically to all of the big bodies Regis has been something to watch. It's basketball poetry. Mattella crossover moves, guarded by Gonzalez. Now Wild over to Eubanks. She fakes, goes inside, going left, and a good take. She doesn't quite finish it, but she will go to the line for two. Pacheco called for that one. And Whalen comes in. Searcy comes out in what will likely be her final game with the Regis Pride as a senior. We want to give a shout-out to all the seniors on both sides of the court today who have worked their way up. It's been a particularly tough season navigating through COVID protocols and all of the cancellations and changes. But these two teams have risen to be terrific. GNAC powers the Saints dominant for years, and for Regis, an emerging team perhaps. And it'll be interesting to follow them in the coming seasons. Whalen goes inside. Kelly thought about it, now brings it back out. But it's tipped away by Faust, and now Eubanks pushing up the floor. Looking over to Mattella. Mattella thought about getting the paint. Instead, kicks it out to Wild. Wild now to Faust. Faust will tee it up. Almost there. And Emmanuel in this quarter, 20 points. And overall, 8 of 16 from 3. Just an offensive explosion. At this point, you say, well, let's save some of the riches for tomorrow as another steal by the Saints. That is, I believe, 21 turnovers by Regis College. It was 30 in the Norwich game. You are looking at a defense in Emmanuel College that has forced 51 turnovers in two games. Absolutely staggering, but if you've been watching this team, following them like we have all year, it's no surprise. Faust misses her first. And coming to the game is Donis, the senior guard. As Faust splits the pair at the charity stripe. And with 2:04 to go, the Saints in command, 25-point lead. And this is something that the Emmanuel faithful has become accustomed to. Big wins like this. And the Saints have been dominating in really all facets of the game as Gonzalez misses another three. Regis just 4 of 9 from downtown. Regis just 13 made field goals. Emmanuel has made 27. Emmanuel has also taken 18 more field goals because they've been so dominant on defense. Regis hasn't been getting as many shots off. Nice take for Allison Wild. And make that a nice 69 on the day for the Saints. Regis just 42. It's 27. Saints can make this 30 in short order. Really, if they choose to at this point. But, of course, Andy Yosinoff keeping this team engaged. Don't, even though the lead seems out of reach, you just want to continue playing. You play to the final horn. And that jumper short by Doherty. And the frustration continues for Regis. And it's certainly difficult anytime you come in to a place like this. In the Fenway area, driving here. Of course, Regis College. It's a short drive, but with the day's delay, you have that extra day to prepare, but for the Saints, just gave them another chance to refocus and really, really just retool things. Mattel, 1 of 2. And the third quarter, under a minute to play. And it's all smiles on the Saints bench. What a fitting story. Whalen on the take. No good there. Good rebound by Hunt. Just, again, such a hungry player. She brings energy. She plays great defense. And she can, she's got a nice little jumper as Eubanks finishes. Eubanks with 4. And when you look up and down this roster, it really feels like everyone on this roster has had their day. Double-digit performance, a couple big baskets. The depth is insane on the Saints roster. Doherty trying to navigate the baseline. Gets it over to Gonzalez. Gonzalez tried to step into it. Guarded by Faust. Crossover moves with the shot clock winding down and blocked by Eubanks. Eubanks on the denial. Rifle pass by Matella to Barker. And counted at the buzzer. And that makes it a 30 ball for the Saints. The dominance continues in what has been just an absolute trouncing. Now, Alex Shipps here with you on ECTV. And we keep our eyes towards the GNAC championship game, which will be tomorrow. No matter who it is, they'll be coming to Andy Yosinoff Court. And no score update right now. It's still 37-34. They are at the half. Albertus with a close lead and two very quality teams. Saints played an the Saints blew out St. Joseph's Maine at home and then played an absolute barn burner up in Maine where Wild hit the game-winning shot in overtime. And for Albertus, that was a game that the Falcons sort of hung around for a while, but ultimately Albertus got the job done. You look at the scoring here. And Diamond White really stepping up for Albertus. Hannah Talon has 11 to match Diamond White. So again, the game to keep an eye on as we welcome you here to the fourth quarter. And what is has been really all Saints all day, 74-42. Just seeing the way the Saints, they know they tend to get off to slow starts, but once they get their feet wet, once they get their toes wet, they really take over games. As Barker, no good on the jumper. The Pride trying to get in the paint. It's Kelly, dishes it out to Doherty, who's short on the baseline. Whalen is able to rip it back and score on the offensive rebound. So again, only two players haven't scored. Desiree Robinson and Kenton, who are both on the court right now. We've got Robinson, Hunt, Barker, Faust, Kenton. I'll try and make a play. Hunt. There, Desiree couldn't quite finish. Whalen a couple ball fakes, tries to sort of sidearm it up there and can't get it to go. And a timeout by Andy Yosinoff. And this has been a game where Andy hasn't really called many timeouts. As we go through it here, I'm not sure. I think that might be the first or second timeout. I mean, Andy has really been pleased with their performance today. Now, the caution with that is you don't want to, of course, get too excited about it. You do have a game tomorrow, as it looks, the GNAC Championship, the all-important one. And again, in a game that has just been all Saints for a good long while now, you kind of scramble for answers if you're Regis, but you can certainly take pride in what was a fun run to the GNAC semifinals. They won their game against St. Joseph CT, 68-50. And that's one of the real joys of playoff basketball, as the shot clock went off by accident. And it looks like there was a backcourt violation by Faust. Ball will go back to the Pride. And again, all smiles for the Saints. And this is great, too. You get your more veteran starters, lots of rest. Riley Lahiff, Lauren D'Agostino. Actually, all of your starters currently sitting on the bench. We have a few that head to the locker room, and we'll be back soon. Wild and Mattel just left the locker room. As Gonzalez goes lefty right there. One of the few lefties in the GNAC, and she has a good finish there. It's one that Corey Mathis was telling me about. One of the few lefties like her to play. And again, just exciting to see Emmanuel's bench pieces getting some reps in a game like this. What a move by Amari Faust. Goes up and over and finishes lefty. Faust with 5 on the day. And she picks Kelly's pocket. Make that, yeah, that was Doherty. And then goes the other end. She'll go to the free throw line. She went right off the steal. It all smiles after that once again. And I think if you want to compare games here, in the Norwich game, the Saints were also dominant defensively. The difference was they couldn't make a lot of the patented shots. Riley Hiff wasn't knocking down those baseline jumpers. D'Agostino had missed a few. But Metella came in and really energized them. But the Saints were just making their shots a lot more efficiently in this one. So Faust misses both. Regis just crosses center court with 7 minutes and almost 20 seconds to play here. A steal by Hunt there. And they're going to slow it down per Andy's orders. Hunt now, left shoulder, tries to look to Robinson or make that Eubanks, who uses her length to stay, keep it in. And how about a nice turning shot by Hunt? And that's something you can admire about Angel Hunt. She's a player who is working her way up in this program, and she can make tough shots. I mean, really a great physical big, and someone that once she adjusts to the play style that Andy likes, fast, up-tempo. And just making the most out of these turnovers, then she's going to be something really special. She really will. And I was talking to my broadcast colleague, Matt LePan, about that in the previous game, and that's something you definitely notice. Hunt is a standout player. Nice block by Eubanks. Once, how about twice? Faust sees Barker. Will we get another score? Not quite, but Barker will go to the line, and she's not happy about that, but Barker will get there, and the officials are debating whether or not that's a flagrant or not. Looks like they're just going to call it a push. So Doherty and Whalen come out. Pacheco comes in. And Donis also coming in for the Pride. Regis still has not crossed the 50-point mark. Emmanuel looking at 80. Women's team, of course, a blowout against Norwich on Wednesday night. Men's team had a blowout on Tuesday night. And we want to give a shout-out to Emmanuel College men's basketball as well. Their season, unfortunately, ended against Anna Maria. But a team that you may have thought this was a transition year because Tel White, first year as the head coach. But he kept those guys focused, and it's really exciting to see what the men's team will do. Some great additions like Dante Pope and Bryant Sissio, who have stepped up in their first years. So we give a shout out to them in what will sure to be an exciting era of men's basketball. Ball is tipped around, Hunt controls it, looks inside to Robinson, and she scores. Desiree Robinson gets on the board, and I think there's only one player who hasn't scored thus far. And that is Kettin, who is currently not on the court. Looks like she headed to the locker room. And Gonzalez makes a three there. Saints a 31-point lead. Just staggering. But something that has happened on so many occasions this season, just so many of these kind of games. Nice take for Eubanks. Couldn't quite finish. She's very good at that right jab step. Go left. Go right to the heart of the defense. And if that's going to be one of her patented moves, it's exciting to see where she'll take that. Three by Gonzalez, bounces in. And she makes another to get Regis over the 50 mark. She's got 19. But again, someone that the Saints really held in tow when the game was a lot closer. And let's talk about Emmanuel's day a little bit more. Saints shooting 57% still. And that's considering that they were really giving the bench a lot of time, even early on in the third quarter. Pass is deflected there by Eubanks. Whalen handoff to Gonzalez, who can't quite finish, going lefty again. Rifle pass to Barker, far side by the Saints logo. Now by the St. Bernard ear, it's Faust. Looking to dribble this thing down a little bit. We're halfway through the fourth quarter. The Saints, just 6 points in this quarter. It would be the first quarter, if trends continue, where Regis would outscore the Saints. So you want to talk about wall-to-wall dominance. And Robinson picked up a steal there, is able to sort of roll it over to Barker. And now let's talk about these statistics again. Saints shooting 56% from the field. Just 38 for Regis, 17 of 45 for them. And Eubanks almost finishes there. She'll go to the line. Eubanks doing a great job of drawing fouls right now, and someone who really uses her length well, a big who has been more than serviceable when she's been called upon to make key plays, whether it's offensively or defensively, always uses her length well. She's got two. And Eubanks has five now after that free throw. And makes her second. So let's talk again about these statistics. The Saints outscoring really in every department. 30 to 18 points in the paint. That's been a huge difference. The Saints have really made barbecue chicken out of Regis, as Shaquille O'Neal has said so many times. Just really exploiting weaknesses in the paint, particularly on the left block. And that has been just something to behold. 44 to 4 is the bench points total. And that's, if Regis is looking for some scouting tips there, that's really it. Gotta build a deeper roster. Eubanks, nice dish! And Robinson couldn't finish, got her own rebound, over to Hunt. Now Barker, she goes right. Pulls up on the block, can't quite get it to go. That was a jumper that fell off the back iron. Doherty trying to dribble in the paint now. Tries to scoop it up, no. Rebound Faust. And let's talk about these GNAC games a little bit more. Right now, St. Joseph's made up by four in the third quarter against Albertus Magnus. There's 2.5 to go in the quarter. St. Joseph's outscoring the Falcons 17 to 10. Regis getting a stop. Pam Gonzalez now baseline. Gets it over to Doherty, who thought about it. Now she'll take it, and it looked like she was going for the bank. Can't quite bend it her way. And so now 82 to 55. The Saints keep pouring it on. And let's talk again about the Saints. 21 assists to just 10 by Regis. That's 21 assists on 33 field goals. So Saints doing an excellent job with shot creation, distributing the ball. They have just great offensive chemistry, something that I mentioned earlier on in the broadcast. And that's really what does the job for them. 44 bench points. They just get so many different contributions, whether it's Barker, Metella. It's just excellent all around. And a nice move for Robinson. She's got four on the day and under 2 minutes to play in this one. Again, the winner of this one, which I think it's fair to say, it's beyond fair to say, will be the Saints. We'll host the winner of the St. Joseph's Maine Albertus Magnus game. Currently 51 to 49. Something to keep an eye on. For updates about the game, including game time and matchup, keep an eye on goecsaints.com. And again, shout out to our outstanding athletic department and SIDs. And of course, partners like Max Spellman Realty and Coca-Cola. As you see a turnover there from Emmanuel. And again, you ask yourself, how does a team like Emmanuel do this so consistently throughout the season? It's because they're a cohesive unit. They're well coached. They play well in the passing lanes, and they play well in the paint. They've got defensive bulldogs left and right. Riley Lahiff, Jamad Finn, Olivia Metella can get steals. Lauren D'Agostino gets a lot of steals, too. So they always have great anticipation, great active hands. Their defense is their specialty. And that's what will take them to the brink of a GNAC championship as the Saints look to win their third consecutive GNAC crown. And the party to get there is underway here. Saints up 84 to 60. Barker turns it over. And Regis finally bringing in some of their bench, such as Lauren Lividoti. And a timeout call to get some more substitutes in. So that'll be Katie Hart coming into the game. And Shannon Kelly getting a senior standing ovation. Same for Searcy. And Pam Gonzalez hugging her teammates as well. It's been a fun season for Regis. Unfortunately, it had to come to an end today. And for Emmanuel, with what a block by Hunt, just to add a little oomph to what has already been a game full of praise. And the fans get on their feet, give it a listen. 84-60. Your Emmanuel College Saints march on to face the winner of the Albertus Magnus St. Joseph's main game in the GNAC Championship. Exciting times here at Andy Yosinoff Court. The Saints a defensive masterpiece with brilliant offense to complement it. And they win 84-60. Again, Emmanuel College moving on. Alex Ships for ECTV. Have a great night, everyone. We'll be back with you tomorrow afternoon. Stay tuned on GoECSaints.com for more information about that. Take care, everybody.
So cool that, like, because you know, we have family members come in. I was actually, I think that's Lauren's dad over there. So we have, it's so cool to just see the reach that we have, because, you know, we don't have, like, marketing statistics to see who's listening, but it's so cool to see all the people. Get some points in the next game too. It's going to be a fun one.